In just 1 hour, students will walk through the doors at Butler High School. It's going to be their first time doing so since a deadly shooting in their hallways.
That shooting killing 16-year-old Bobby McKeithen and sending another 16-year-old, Jatwan Cuffey, behind bars. And now we're being told that there were tensions long before that shooting took place on Monday morning. NBC Charlotte's Ruby Durham is live at the school in Matthews. So, Ruby, we learned that there was actually a fight in the Harris Teeter parking lot before the shooting took place.
That's right, Carolyn. And now today, extra police are on scene already to help students heal with this process that they're dealing with. Crisis counselors will also be in today from 9 to 2. And if you look closely, you'll see the flag being flown at half staff to honor the life that was taken too soon.
I think whether you knew him or not, you're still hurting. He was part of the community. He was part of our school.
Court documents painting a vivid picture of the timeline that led up to Monday's fatal shooting. Jatwan Cuffey says the fight on Friday inside a Harris Teeter parking lot between him and four other teens ended when he ran away after someone pulled a knife. Cuffey admitted Bobby McKeithen, the victim in Monday's tragic shooting, was watching nearby and that he was led to believe another fight would happen in the coming days. Now fast forward to Monday, when Cuffey says he went into the woods and got a gun for protection, the very gun reported stolen. Cuffey says when he arrived at Butler on Monday, McKeithen walked up and punched him in the face. He pulled out the gun and fired one shot. Yolanda Troutman, a longtime Charlotte attorney and former judge, says different measures could be used as a defense in the case, as Cuffey now faces first-degree murder.
If they are considering self-defense, they have to be very specific.
Ben and Carolyn, the superintendent and police now going back to the drawing board, going over security procedures and expenses to see how they can prevent this from ever happening again. I'm reporting live from Matthews, Ruby Durham. Back to you in the studio.
Ruby, thanks so much. And in the wake of that deadly shooting at Butler High School, officials are talking about what Ruby just mentioned, what they need to do to make schools safer.
And it all comes down to, you guessed it, money. The News and Observer reporting that the Department of Public Instruction is requesting $71 million more for next year's budget. Now, in total, it will cost the state $688 million to hire enough counselors, psychologists, and school resource officers for all state schools.